Hi, and welcome back to Wisconsin Family. We are having a lovely time at Robinia Courtyard. Myself and Rich Reynolds are here hosting and having a really good time. This is a fun dynamic.
Absolutely.
I'm enjoying myself.
Yeah, gorgeous day, gorgeous setting.
Yeah.
And, you know, for people that haven't been back here, check it out.
Yeah,
800 block of East Washington, like Kitty Corner from Bree Stevens Field.
Yep.
There's so much that's been going on in this neighborhood,
mm-hmm.
and it is a lot of fun.
It's popping.
It's a great setting, yeah.
It is, and we're going to hear about what's happening around the neighborhood in the courtyard. This is Mr. Armando Magana. He essentially runs the Black Locust Cafe here within the restaurant group at Robinia Courtyard. So you're kind of up in the cafe stuff, but you're all up in what's going on out here too. So tell us a little bit about events, things we can expect in the courtyard.
Yeah, space. Yeah. I think both John and I are kind of running around doing everything at this point. So I'm in the cafe, I'm in the tap room, and specifically in the courtyard, I think the idea that John and I had is that we really wanted this place to be active and vibrant almost every single day of the week, which is hard to do, right?
Yeah.
Like, you can't have something going on at all times, but we definitely try. And so we sat down and we came up with, you know, we were just throwing ideas at the wall and we wanted to see what stuck, so we kind of just started doing different ideas. And, you know, we have music every Monday night.
Okay.
You know, the band sets up in the back of the courtyard. The beer's flowing and
yeah.
the beard is coming out.
It
and
sounds wonderful, by the way. Why are we not here? Monday.
And, you know, there's always a different vibe, right? You know, it could be like an acoustic kind of mellow night. Everyone's drinking wine, or, you know, a Latin jazz fusion band and there's people dancing.
Good.
And it's a lot of fun, yeah.
We were talking before how this feels like you're kind of in a little vacation spot back here.
Right.
It's surrounded by these beautiful trees. You've got a lot of, like, plant life and different kinds of tiki feel almost. Not with, I don't know, maybe that's the wrong word,
right.
but there's just something about this environment that really makes you feel like you're on vacation. And I imagine coming out here and having some cool lights hanging and, you know, dancing a little bit, it must feel like that little getaway for people.
Yeah, it is fun. It's, you know, I think because it's kind of tucked away from the street, it creates this kind of private energy of just kind of this, like, inclusive kind of fun vibe that I think people really enjoy.
Yeah.
It feels almost like you're having a private party with all your friends, even though
this is my dance space.
Right,
kind of
right.
Everybody gets to belong.
Everyone can come out.
I absolutely love that you do some stuff like on a Monday night.
Yeah,
now, being in the
that.
Restaurant business for a long time, service industry people, like, our weekends were Mondays and Tuesdays.
Absolutely.
And there was never
right.
anything going on. So the fact that you do that, I think it's great. Do you get a lot of service industry people then that come out for a night like that?
It's interesting. There's a couple of people I know who come in who play a lot of ping pong here. We have the table tennis table set up.
Oh.
I think we're gonna do a tournament eventually.
If
enough
yeah.
people come out. So yeah, it's we got service industry people coming. All
That's
sorts
awesome.
Of people, yeah.
Ping pong out there. I know I have quite a group of friends who are very into it on a competitive level, and then who are into it in a bar level, and both. So if
right.
you're out there and you're a ping pong player, I didn't know you had a table here.
We do. When
That's
we're getting
exciting.
Another one, so yeah, we're.
Oh, people will be here for a tournament in a heartbeat.
It's great, yeah.
That's awesome.
Sure. Yeah.
Well, learning stuff all the time. Okay, so you have a Monday night event. We've heard we've got some acoustic music. You come out here, have some beer or wine. What other nights of the week are you know is happening and what's going on?
Right after that, Tuesday nights are our movie nights,
and so outside.
Outside, yeah.
Oh, that's so
cool. We project the movie on three different walls here, so you can kind of sit anywhere and enjoy
fun.
It. You know, we have it in the tap room as well. And so our idea is to, every new month in the tap room, we get a different brewery, right?
Okay.
And so we ask the brewmaster or the owner, hey, what's your favorite movie? Right?
Oh, cool.
So then, you know, they come out for the movie night, they watch their favorite movie, hang out with guests, and talk
and
about
beer.
And they
can kind of be the face behind their beer at that time and really get in and hang out with the people that are drinking their beer.
Right,
what
right.
better way to sell your brand?
Exactly.
Right?
That's
super
yeah,
cool.
Yeah. And, you know, they've picked some good movies.
Like what?
Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
Yes.
Excellent movie.
Peter, who owns One Barrel, I think has The Fifth Element as one of his favorite movies, which is kind of a weird movie, but that was like one of our best nights, right? Because one of his beers is The Fifth Element Rye IPA. And
oh, right
yeah,
on.
So that was fun night.
Full circle, yeah.
Bruce Willis,
cool.
Chris Tucker.
Yeah, that's a lot of fun.
Great
yeah.
movie.
Yeah.
Well, and that's
it
such
is.
A cool way to have these business owners, and correct me if I'm wrong about the tap room, what you do is have essentially like a tap takeover once a month by a different brewery in the community, right?
Right, yeah.
So this is a way to get your, if you're you know a small batch brewery owner, craft beer, this is a way to get your beer for the whole month highlighted in a bar. And
yeah.
that's all that's in there, right?
Yeah.
For that whole month. That is such a neat concept, don't you think?
Yeah,
you ever heard of
absolutely.
Like
no, and I think that's got to be a big boom, you know, for those brewmasters to be somewhere else besides their own place a lot of times, you know, and get their name out there. So I love that they're also involved with something like that and that you guys are doing that. Is that like kind of the focus? You guys put a lot of focus on having local vendors and local items in?
Oh, yeah. You know, our chef is very adamant about working with local, you know, which isn't a new thing, but I think it's a good thing for the industry as a whole. So he's very, you know, passionate about that. And then I think, you know, our idea is Wisconsin breweries, and there's like, what, over 100? So we'll be working local for the time being.
There's a lot of material for local brewery in this area, isn't there?
It's
we like our
great
beer.
Time to be a drinker. You know, there's distilleries and wineries and breweries and to have that kind of stuff, and then kind of central, you know, centrally located right here and have all the stuff going on. Great setting. So we talk Monday nights, Tuesday nights. What else you guys got going on?
Thursday nights is kind of, it's our more kind of vibey, kind of hipper night. We got DJs coming in. It's a very like, I don't know, it's cool. It's just so fun to hear kind of Latin DJ spinning or just like some really weird ambient stuff. Thursday nights are fun and kind of off center. It's pretty nice.
Off center is good for Madison though, because I mean, I think that there is a lot of things that's kind of become the norm around this community as far as, like we were kind of talking about, you know, it's a good day to be a drinker, but people like to go out and have their beers and stuff like that. So if you want to do something a little bit different, but again, to me, I always crave places that you can be outside and enjoy your social event, right? So if you come here, you're in this environment, and you do want to do something a little bit different and get your dance on, and I hear there's like a light show, is that right?
Or some kind of action. You know, like that? The DJs will bring their own kind of fun stuff.
So you feel like you're in the club, but you're outside. That is why that's so special, I think. Right. So, okay, so we have DJs, we've got acoustic, we've got beer, we've got wine. Let's remind people, too, one of the other huge efforts in this restaurant group is Black Locust Cafe, which I know you have excellent coffee because I have it every time I'm here.
Right.
Hit on a couple of the other items that someone could get if they were hungry and at Black Locust.
Yeah, you know, we have a pretty extensive crepe menu. I think we really like making the crepes, and bringing that to Madison is always fun. We have our bings, which are... It's a Chinese kind of breakfast street food in origin, so the original one we have, and it's very delicious. People from the province of Shandong have come and said, this is great.
Really?
So that's kind of a nice thing. And then we do our own takes on that, so that's very fun.
And when you say, you know, just, we're running out of time here, but I just want to explain to people, in case they don't know exactly what a bing is. Can you give us
a
summary?
Crispy crepe wrap, you know? We crisp it up. Yeah, it's good.
We crisp it up? Love it.
Bada bing.
Bada bing. Exactly. That always comes to mind when I think bings.
Yep.
Exactly. Armando, thank you so much for filling us in on what's going on in the courtyard. There's a lot of summer left, so do not miss this area. Robinia Courtyard outside. Do anything you like socially out here. They give you a good time. Armando, Black Locust Cafe, Robinia Courtyard. Thank you so much for joining us today on Wisconsin Family. And join us for more programming on Wisconsin's 57 Television. The beat, clap your hands, let it take